Probably you have heard of Jupyter Notebook. In this video, I'll show you how to use Jupyter Notebook as a cloud-based service. So Jupyter Notebook, if you don't know what it is, Jupyter Notebook is an IDE where you write code. But the structure of this IDE is very different from the other standard IDEs. You'll see exactly what this structure is about. So in this video, I'll show you how to use a cloud-based Jupyter Notebook. And this is made available by Deepnote.com. So in order to have access to this cloud-based Jupyter Notebook IDE, you need to create an account on Deepnote.com. And it's completely free. So please create an account and then log in, and you should see this dashboard here. So in this video, I'll give you a tour on using Deepnote. So even if you don't know how to use Jupyter Notebooks, you'll learn how to use them in here, because Deepnote is based on Jupyter Notebooks. What you see here are the projects, the Jupyter Notebooks that I have on Deepnote.com. So these are existing projects. If you have created a fresh account, you'll probably not have any projects in here. But you can create one using this new project button. And then new Deepnote project. And a new notebook should open up. A notebook is made of cells. So this here is a cell. And you can create more cells by clicking this button here or using these shortcuts from your keyboard. So now we have two cells. So what is a cell? A cell is like a Python script. You can have some code here like print hello, print bye, and execute. You can execute this with this button or this shortcut combination of keys. And you should get the output. And then you have another cell which serves as a new script, separate script. So x equal to 10, print x, execute, you get 10. You can create more cells, so you have more scripts. But notice something here, you can access a variable from another cell. For example, you can print x here, and x was defined in another cell, but you can still access it. You can add more cells, for example, above this existing cell by pressing on code, and it adds a cell above that. Or press here on code to add the cell in here. You can delete these cells by using this button or this shortcut, and that as well. And you can also add blocks, and not only code cells, but also blocks. A block can be code, so we used code already, but it can also be a heading, or heading 2, heading 3, or a paragraph of text and other elements. So let's try heading 1. My first notebook. So that's the title, and then we can add perhaps a heading 2, printing out text, for example. Another one in here. Printing out variables, and so on. So now you probably understand why this is called a notebook. So this is a Jupyter notebook, and it's cloud-based. That means you can share this notebook with other people. So you can go here and press that button, and then you can define if you want your notebook to be edited or just viewed. So if you select view and then you copy this code and you give it to someone, for example, let me open a private window and you paste that. You know, they have view access and they can see the code now. And they can duplicate this notebook, so then they can have a copy of this notebook on their account. So basically, they will have a different project using the same code. And if you want to collaborate, then you want to go here, manage collaborators. So you can invite someone by adding their email address, and then you'll be able to code with someone else on the same notebook. How about installing third-party libraries? For example, if you want to import speech recognition, which is a third-party library to do speech recognition from audio, so converting audio to text, if you execute that, you're going to get an error. But you can install third-party libraries using an exclamation mark followed by pip install and the name of the third-party package. In this case, the name of this package is uppercase S, so speech recognition. So in this case, it's a bit different from the import statement here. So you execute that, and Deepnote will install that library for you. So it's successfully installed. Now you can try again, import, you get no errors, you can use the library in the notebook. And that concludes the tour on Deepnote. Finally, I'm going to rename the project to some more meaningful name. My first notebook, for example, and press enter. And that's our notebook. So thank you for following, and I'll talk to you later.